So, first of all, Pam and Frankie, I toast your serenity. It has been a long, hard journey to get here. Here today and tonight, I know how hard it's been. But despite all, you made it together. And you will continue to overcome together.
On behalf of Pam and Frankie, I would like to thank you all for being here today, for taking the time and making the journey, and for all the effort that it takes, not only to be a part of this day, but to be a part of their lives. So today, we should try to remember that a wedding is a symbol, a heartfelt and meaningful symbol, but a symbol nonetheless. The ceremony is not magic. It will not create a relationship that doesn't already exist and has not already been celebrated in all the commitments Pam and Frankie have made to each other in the days since they first met. What we're celebrating today is not the beginning of a marriage, but a marriage already in progress. The symbolic vows that you two are about to take are a way of saying to one another, you know, all the things we promised and that we've hoped and we've dreamed, we meant it all, every word. Nothing is easier than standing here and saying those words, and nothing is more difficult than living them day to day. What you promise today must be renewed and reaffirmed tomorrow and for all the tomorrows to come.
From the day we met, you have always pushed and challenged me. You have made my life full of happiness, laughter, and love, of adventure, exploration, and growth. You temper my inner crankiness and challenge me to be a better man.
Frankie, I love you. Several times over, we have had the rug pulled out from under us, where we've always found our footing. We have shrunk and expanded, wilted and bloomed, suffered and healed. Through each experience, we lived and we grew together. We emerged stronger, happier, and better versions of our prior selves. Today, I not only choose you to be my partner, but also vow to be yours.
I love you so much. I promise to love, honor, and respect you.
I promise to love you not only when it is easy to love you, but especially when it is difficult to love you. I promise to see you and appreciate you. I promise to put us first and put in the effort to be the wife and companion you deserve.
For all the days, nights, and otherwise, the rest of my life. I take you for now and for always. For always is always now.
I take you for now and for always. For always is always now.
It is now my honor and delight to declare you husband and wife. You may seal your vows with a kiss.
I mean, romantic poems, they're usually corny. They don't really land as cheesy these days. But you know, standing here tonight, can't help but get a little sentimental. In fact, I am thankful for romantic poetry. Without romantic poetry, I wouldn't have met Pam. Well, next, Pam's second favorite poet from New York, Harlem, Cameron Ezekiel Giles, also known as Cameron. Ayo. Ayo. Why am I gonna sit here and let y'all bug me? Cause I met a dime piece and that girl lovely.
Sit here and let y'all bug me, cause I met a dime and a girl is lovely. And don't we in love, we ain't no lovey dovey.
And her stuff hot and divine, and the thing she cops top of the line.
And her stuff hot and divine, and the thing she got top of the line. I'm thinking hopping behind, maybe popping some wine.
Ain't nobody getting that, just me. And ain't nobody hitting that, just me.
Cause ain't nobody getting that, just me. And ain't nobody hitting that, just me.
It's all good.
Stop.
It's all good. Loving somebody.
Somebody loves you back.
As somebody loves you back.
It's all good. Yeah. Loving somebody. Somebody loves you back.
Hey. May you always share peace, laughter, and everlasting love. And maybe a little poetry too.
You've always been a great friend and a great big brother, and no matter how many times I've screwed up and continue to screw up, you're always there to forgive me and be there for me, being there for groomsmen and vice versa. So just want to say I love you, Frankie. Time check. Okay, sorry. Pam? Okay. I feel like you and I are kindred spirits. I see a lot of similarities, and also Frankie has mentioned this and agreed with me before that I think he thinks that you are the female version of me. Take what you want from that.
Oh, no.
Ask him, is it true? Frankie, did you say that? Yep. Yep. First time we met, I know it was only a short ride on a subway, so it was very neutral. Second time we met, I insulted you, I apologize. Third time we met, you insulted me back.
Got you.
We've been friends ever since.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here's to Frankie and Pam. Love you guys.
At this moment, I'll read one of Pam's favorite English poets, Matthew Arnold. When our world deafened ear is suddenly by a loved one's tones caressed. A bolt is shot back into our breast. And a lost pulse of feeling stirs again. An eye sinks inward and our heart lies plain. What we mean, we say. And what we would, we know.